One of the things I love about Canva is that it's constantly evolving. And today I'm going to go through some of the exciting new additions and enhancements that have literally just been announced in this past month. Plus, if you hang around till the end, I am going to be giving you a sneak peek of two of the most exciting updates that Canva have announced for a long time. But first, let's kick off with a little magic. This year's Droptober has delivered a lot of really good stuff, and I'm only going to cover the updates that I think are particularly relevant. But if there is something that you would specifically like a more detailed demo of, please just drop a comment below the video and let me know, and I'll add that to the list of upcoming videos. Also, two things to note. First of all, in the description below the video, I will leave a link to the Canva webpage that has an overview of all of these Droptober updates and announcements so that you can read through those whenever you've got time. It's also worth noting that some of the updates are only available to people who are on Pro or Teams Canva accounts, so please keep that in mind, particularly as today I'm working in my Teams account. So let's start with a little enhancement to one of the most popular AI tools within Canva called Magic Write. Magic Write is essentially Canva's AI-enabled writing assistant, and it allows you to use prompts like any other AI tool to quickly create written content. You can use it for social posts, business plans, websites, blogs, a whole load of things. It generally works best when it's used in Canva Docs, but it is available in other designs. Now, Canva has announced an update to Magic Write, and basically what it does is it essentially allows more flexibility and power to refine the prompts that you use and you give it, and so get better results. You can use commands like more like this to expand the content, and simple things like this but to refine and edit what's already created for you. And Canva promises that this will help create more accurate and relevant content that fits more seamlessly into your writing and your style. Now, this is a great step forward for Magic Write, but for me, Magic Write is still so far behind things like ChatGPT that it's just not quite worth the time investment to get it to work the way that I really need it to, compared to the power of the more robust AI tools. But it is a great move forward for this tool within the Canva ecosystem. A new AI tool that was announced is called DreamLab, which is essentially another AI image creator. Now, first of all, this is not available to everybody yet, but it is already rolling out, so I'm sure we'll all have access to it soon. Now, the demo I've seen had showed that it's a very capable tool, but the demo also clearly shows it needs a lot of details in the prompt to work well and to create really refined images. And unfortunately, they still look like every other AI-generated image. Now, I know these tools can be useful, but for me, like with all the AI image tools so far, it's just not worth the huge amount of time needed to use it well and produce high-quality results. The results are too generic and they look too similar to every other AI image tool for it to really be of value for me. Plus, I would actually rather use that time to search for photos of and created by actual human beings. Now, speaking of photos of actual human beings, let's talk about some very cool new stock resources that have just been added to the Canva libraries. The first is POC stock. Now, this is just for their photos, and this is one that I'm very excited about. POC stock is essentially a media platform that focuses on diverse representation in stock assets. They offer a library of royalty-free stock photos, videos, illustrations, and all of these feature people from a variety of backgrounds that you don't often see included. So Black, Asian, Hispanic, Native, Middle Eastern, LGBTQIA+, people with disabilities, body positive images, and even people who are older. And Canva has been really outspoken about their commitment to diversity and inclusion. And to be honest, it's one of the reasons I like them as a company. But this is a great step towards that goal of better representation and better diversity in our stock images. Now, the easiest way to find them is to search for @POCstock in the Elements tab, and then you can filter by photos. And if you click on the info for one of those photos, you can then click on the Creator tag, and then you can search within that POCstock library for more images, and you can refine it with your own search terms. Another great collection that's just been added comes from one of the most popular professional stock libraries. I'm talking about Artlist. Now, Artlist is a website that provides royalty-free music, sound effects, video footage, video templates, and all sorts of other creative assets specifically for video creators. I've used them for years for different projects, and they really have a great selection of really high-quality assets. Now, for Canva, they have only added their stock videos to the Canva library, but that's a great enhancement. So again, you can search in the Elements tab within Canva for @Artlist, and you can then filter just to videos, and you'll see that they have a huge selection of really nice professional looking video assets. And lastly, Canva has added a huge library of popular music tracks to the audio library. They're tracks that are more up to date, the more popular, the things you'll hear on TikTok or Instagram all the time. And there's also a collection of templates in the template library that already include those popular music tracks. Although it's incredibly tricky to actually find the templates. At the moment, I couldn't find them by searching in the templates library for popular music. The easiest way to find those is to explore the creators section, which is on the left in this tab, and then find popular music as a creator. And then you can follow them and that way find more of those templates more easily. If you find it tricky to find these, I will be sharing direct links to these creators in this week's newsletter. So please make sure that you've signed up for that. Now, let's get a little animated. One of the most fun releases for Droptober has been a set of new animations that are available in Canva, which I thought I would demonstrate for you today and just give you a few tips on how to use them to their full potential. So on the first page, I have imported an image here from the Canva library. It's actually one of the images from POC stock. And if we hit on the animate button, once we've clicked on the image, you'll see the menu pops up. And on the left-hand side, we have access to these 6 new animations, which are listed under the featured animations. Now, you may have little labels on them that say that they're new, but because I've been playing with them, those aren't there. But these first 6 in featured are our new animations. And if I just hover over them, you'll see the effect on that image. So the first is a brush effect, which is a bit like a paintbrush. The second one is like ink, so it's got this kind of bleeding ink effect. The third is a digital kind of pixelation effect. The fourth is a spray paint effect with these kind of spray paint edges. The next is a bit like pencil sketches, so similar to the brush effect. And the last is these kind of gradient shapes. Now, as always, when you click on them, you've got a few options for each of these. So we're going to go through those really quickly. So for the brush option, again, you can animate both on enter, exit, or both. And then you've got 4 different styles. Now, the first or default one is this kind of curve, which brushes from left to right. The next one is called wild. And that's just this kind of haphazard effect of almost like brush strokes of different brushes across the page. Then you also have the dip effect, which goes just like big brush strokes diagonally, and then the swirl effect, which is in a kind of spiral shape to the center. I think they're really fun, and I think they've actually done a great job at making them elegant while also being fun. And the same goes for the other ones. If we click on ink, you'll see on this one, you've got 4 options as well. We have what they call seep, which just comes from the bottom to the top and fills in. We have flow, which again is a very similar effect, but from right to left. We've got bloom, which is just from the center out, basically. And then we've got splotches, which looks like drops of ink on kind of wet paper. The digital one is a little more limited. You've only got 3 options, but this could also be great, especially for things that are more modern. The first one is center, where you just have these boxes coming out from the center to reveal the image. The linear one is again just these boxes from left to right. And then the scatter one is a little more haphazard, and I think it could be great as a kind of reveal of one image over the other. So if I hover over that, you'll see it's almost this kind of erratic boxes coming in. And I think that could be a really fun effect for us to use. Scrolling down, we'll have a look at the spray paint one, and that's only got 2 options, but I think they're really fun. The messy one is again just a kind of haphazard almost spray of where this image is revealed. And the next one looks a bit like graffiti letters. They could add a really nice effect to especially things like fashion, things that are geared towards a more younger audience, things that have a more urban feel, or for music with pop music, etc. It's really cool, and again, if it's not overused, it could be really effective. The sketch options are very similar to the brush options. They just give you a few more kind of refined looks. So for fill, it's from left to right. Swipe, again, goes from top to bottom with these big brush strokes. Scratch is more like a thinner pencil over the whole thing to reveal. And then squiggle, again, is a little more haphazard of this kind of rounded brush going over the image. And then lastly, we've got gradient. You've got three different shapes, essentially, that have a gradient effect as they reveal the image. So circular, this goes from one of the corners in these arcs. Blocks is similar to the digital effect, except it's a gradient of these blocks across the image. And then lines is very similar. It goes from bottom to top and reveals the image almost as these kind of strips of image. So these are super fun. I really like them, and I think they could just add a lot more interest. I think they're a little more refined and a little less overused than some of the other animations or transitions that we've seen. The one thing I would like to see with these is some ability to adjust the timing, but I'm not sure we're going to get that just because of how complex they are visually. The other thing I wanted to point out is that these animations, as you saw, apply to images, but they also apply to videos. So if I just play this video and I do the same thing, you'll see that the video actually comes in using those animations and the video plays behind it. But another thing that's worth mentioning is that you can't add these animations to text boxes. So if you have a look on the left-hand side here, we have our standard animations, but we don't have those new featured animations. You can't do that on anything that's editable like these text boxes, or on anything that's a shape, or any of the elements from the elements library. You would have to find a way around that. And here's a tip for how you can do that. If we go back to the page that's got the text on, if you wanted to animate this text using one of those new animations, you could click on Share, and then if you go to See All and have a look through your options here, you'll see one that says Copy to Clipboard, and it basically takes a screen grab of just this slide or page in your design. So if I click that, it will ask me which page, and page 3 is the one that I want. I'm going to say Copy to Clipboard, and it will then copy a still image of this. If I then go back to this page and just hit Control V to paste, you'll see that it actually pastes an image version of this. But it does have the background as part of it. So if I change the slide background to a darker color, you'll see that it grabbed the background as well. So while I could animate that as an image now using that brush effect, if I wanted to just animate the text, I would just scale this up. And then because it's now an image, I could use the background remover and it will remove that solid color background. So now you'll see I've got one that's the text behind and one that's the actual image. The only thing I would mention is that the text box, obviously, you can edit the text in. Once you've made it an image, you can no longer edit that text or change it. But it does mean if I just delete the text box and I now have the image, I can then just click and drag the little handles to crop to closer around the text to make it easier to manage because I've removed the background. And then because it's an image, if I go to animate, I have the option to use all of those animations that we've just looked at. And the sketch one looks particularly great with handwritten fonts. One last thing I do want to mention here is that the animations should help convey the message, not distract from it. So as always, I suggest that you use those animations sparingly and work on the basis that fewer animations will have more impact. Now, let's get to what I think are the two most impactful updates that Canva have announced. Before I show those to you though, if you found this video helpful and you want to know more about just what Canva is really capable of, I'd love it if you would join my weekly newsletter called Meaningful Creations. It goes out every week and it has new Canva tutorials, resources, insights, and design inspiration. And best of all, it's free to sign. If you just head to the link that's on the screen right now, you can just add in your email address and become part of that crew. And I'd love to see you there. Okay, so as promised, back to the exciting stuff. The two things Canva announced that I think are the most exciting and will probably be the most used day to day are not available yet, at the time of recording anyway, which I won't lie is incredibly frustrating because I would love to show them to you. The first is an enhancement to the already very cool Mockups app, which I created a video on previously, and I will link to that video up here in the corner. This update to Mockups will essentially allow us to create a mockup out of any image, including our own uploaded images. We'll be able to upload an image, click on it, Then select Edit, and then the mockup app appears within that Edit menu. When we click on that, the app will then recognize any surfaces that could be used as frames for our own content. It will then show us those, and we can choose the surface that will be converted into a placeholder that we can just drag our images or assets into. Now, if this works the way that it should and the way that their little demo video looks, it's going to be amazing for displaying images, designs, and especially digital product grabs. It will be brilliant for online stores and e-commerce. It means that we can use our own brand photography if we already have it. We could just upload that. Or we can source photographs that fit our look and feel in our audience, and we can use those to create our own mockups that nobody else is using. If you can't tell, I am super excited about this, and I honestly cannot wait to try it. But our last Droptober announcement is one that I genuinely think could be a game changer for a lot of people. Now, first of all, there are loads of tools out there that do this already, but if you use Canva, being able to do this within Canva will be amazing. I'm talking about video captions finally coming to Canva. And to make it even more exciting, when this feature launches, Canva says we'll be able to edit the font, the style, the color, even the animation of the captions. This will allow us to create our own brand style for our videos and our social media reels, and it'll give us the flexibility to style it in just the way that we want and make it unique to us. With so much focus on social and short form video and the desperate need for more accessible media, this is such a great move for Canva, and I honestly just can't wait to get it. And that's it for Droptober. Drop me a comment below the video and let me know which update you're most excited by. And also, please keep an eye out, because you know I'm going to do a video on the captions and the mockups when they land. That's it, folks. Have a fabulous week, and I know it's rough out there at the moment, so be kind to each other. See you next week.